So AI has developed representations that help capture both the visible levels of abstraction, structure, for example, and the invisible levels like behavior and function. Therefore, these models are sometimes called structure, behavior, function. Let's take a simple example. All of us are familiar with the household flashlight. You press on the button and light comes out of the bulb. What you can see is the button and the bulb and the body of the flashlight. You can even open the body of the flashlight and you might see some batteries inside the flashlight. That's all you can see. But of course, there is more going on here. To begin with, this particular flashlight has a function. This function is invisible. You can ascribe to it, but it's nowhere inside the body of the bulb. One level at which it is useful to analyze the flashlight is to ask ourselves, what does it do? Not yet, how does it work? Just, what does it do? Its function. Here is a representation of the function. Here is the function create light of that light bulb circuit or the flashlight light bulb circuit. There is some stimulus, some external force on the switch. Initially, there was no light, 0 lumens. And finally, there is some light, 30 lumens. This captures the notion that when I press on the switch, light comes out. Here is a representation of the structure of the flashlight. Here is a light bulb, the switch, and the battery. And they're connected. All of them are attached. Here is the invisible causal process that we are calling behavior. We'll capture this behavior through a series of states and transitions between these states. So here is electricity, initially in the battery. Then this electricity flows from the battery to the bulb. And then the bulb converts this electricity into light. But in order for this electricity to flow through the bulb, this particular switch has to be in the mode on. The switch goes into the mode on when someone presses on it. Electricity is converted into light because that's the function of the bulb. Notice that these SBF models are nested. We just gave an SBF model of the flashlight circuit. But now, if you want, we can get into the SBF model of the light bulb itself. How does it create light? In this way, structure behavior function models capture not just the visible structure, but also the invisible causal processes, the behaviors, and the functions. Moreover, they capture that at multiple levels of abstraction, at the level of the flashlight, at the level of the bulb, and so on. We'll not describe it in detail here, but structure behavior function models and other similar models enable systems thinking in the context of diagnosis and design of complex systems. We provided some readings about this in the course materials if you want to read more about it.